Hey everyone, it's Akshay and welcome back to Daily Tuition. In the first part, we will create a homepage of our website. We are using Visual Code text editor. We had created a folder and open it in the Visual Code editor. In that folder, we created a stock folder and insert some images which we are using in this tutorial series. You can download all these images from the description of the video. Create a new file, index.html. And style.css in the root folder. Then create a simple HTML5 snippet and change the title of your website. Now we want to add Bootstrap in an index.html file. So we will use CDN from the Bootstrap documentation tab and paste it in the head. After that, we need to add JS Bootstrap files. So we will copy these three script tags and paste it just before the closing body tag. We will also link our custom style.css file. First, we will create a Bootstrap carousel. So we will add div with a site header custom class. After that, we will create a div with carousel example ID. Then add carousel and site class. And then add data write carousel. If you don't know how to Bootstrap carousel work, then you can watch Bootstrap carousel complete guide tutorial from here. In this div, create oil tag with the class carousel indicator to indicate which slide has currently been viewed. Then create first list tag for the first image with data target carousel example. And specify data slide 0 and data class active to show an active state of the first image. After that, create another li tag with data target carousel example and add data slide to 1. Then create another li tag with the same data target carousel example and add data slide 2. Now we want to add slides in the carousel. So we will add carousel inner class and add carousel item class with active state. In the first slide, we will add image tag with the background sliding image. In the source, we will specify our first background sliding image and then add alt attribute and class dblock. Create another carousel item with the second carousel sliding image and specify alt and class attribute. And do the same with the third carousel slider, but just change background image in the source. Run project. You will see Bootstrap carousel is created. Now we need to first remove all the padding and margin from all HTML elements. So we will insert a body in the style.css file and specify margin 0 and padding 0. And also specify global font family. Now we want to specify a width to all these sliding images. So we will add width 100% to all these images. Afterwards, we are creating a site content. To do so, we are creating a div with image layer class, and then we will create an image layer class in the style.css file. Here we will specify width 60% and height 110%. Then we will specify position absolute and top 0% and left 0%. After that, insert a background image in the URL. And then specify background size cover and z index 0, and run your project. You will see the panel on the top of the carousel. After that, create a div with the home content class. In this div, we will add h2 heading tag with some text. And then add a paragraph and insert text. After that, we will create a button with the class btn, btn dark, and add download text to this button. Now we want to align all this content, so we will create a home content class in the CSS and specify margin top 30%, width 60%, and margin left 20%. That's it. We had aligned home content where we want to align it. So now we are creating a Bootstrap navigation on the top of the page. To save our time, we will go to the Bootstrap navbar, copy this navbar and paste it here. Now we want to change a few things in this navigation. So we will remove navbar brand text and replace it with daily tuition brand icon. Then we will change nav item features to services and pricing to block, and disable nav item to contact us. Remove this disable class from here. You will see our navigation bar, but it is on the bottom. So now we want to place it on the top. So we will just cut this navigation and place it just after the body tag. Then remove navbar light and bg light class because we want to create a transparent navigation. Okay, now you will see navigation is on the top, but it's actually behind this panel. So we want to take this navigation to the front. So we will create a site header class and add position relative. Then add navbar class, add position absolute and top 0% and z index 2. Now your navigation is on the front. You can navigate through the navigation links now. After that, we want to add nav link class and specify color black to the navigation. And then add some margin to it. So we will add margin right 4 and margin left 4 to home nav item. And then add margin right 4 to all navigation items. That's it. Your home page design is ready. We will learn further in the next part of this tutorial series. If you have any question, then comment me in the comment section. If you find something useful, then click on the like button. We will see you in the next part of this tutorial.